Okay guys, so today we are going to discover another amazing feature which is part of our display rules widget. Again, this is one of the most powerful display condition widget available on the market and most likely the only one you'll ever need to insert visibility conditions on your website. So today we are going to discover how to show or hide dynamic content, and this method will work with ACF, pods and toolset. So this is part 3 of this series, so if you haven't watched the previous 2 videos, we'll leave a link in the description below. My name is Dave from the Plus Add-ons for Elementor. Now don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel as we upload new Elementor videos each week, which will make you an Elementor master in no time. And also, please feel free to share this with your Facebook community so that your friends can learn more about Elementor. Very good, so let's get started. Okay, very good. So for this, we need some dynamic content. So we installed 2 different plugins here. The first one is custom post type. So with this one, we can create a new tab here in the menu section where we can list all our items. So we're going to create a simple car listing today. Now, clearly, each car requires its own set of information. So this is why we installed advanced custom fields. So let me show you very quickly those fields that we created here. So we go into the car fields. And we created something very simple. So how old is the car? Does it have an insurance? Is it under working condition? The cost and the car info, okay? So now if you go into cars here and list all the cars, we created a few. We have BMW, Renault and Ferrari. So if we edit this one here, you will see all these custom fields. So basically this is where they are, okay? So this is how this is working. So this is the basic setup of our dynamic content. And now let's have a look at our landing page. So this is the listing page where all the cars will be listed. And for this, we go back to our WordPress dashboard and we created one here. So car listing. So we can edit this with Elementor. And there you go, guys. So this is our listing page. And if we scroll down the page, we've used a very specific widget for this, which is the dynamic listing, which is part of the Plus add-ons for Elementor Pro. Now, of course, you can use any other means of displaying dynamic content. But for our tutorial here, we're going to use our own widget, which is dynamic listing. So basically here we selected the post type, which is the car. So this is our custom post type. And each single car is using its own template. As you can see here, car template. So we've built all of this using the Plus add-ons for Elementor. And we've used a custom loop as well to display them all here dynamically. Now, if you want to discover more about these different widgets, we'll leave a few links in the description below. We have a few dedicated videos about those subjects. Okay, so let's dive into our display conditions for dynamic content. So let's have a look at our page here in the front end. So this is what it looks like. And as you can see, our 3 cars are being listed. So let's say if we don't enter any price here for the car, we don't want to display the whole section altogether. There is no need to display the dollar sign if there is no price attached to it. So how can we do this? Very simply, we go to our car template, which is this one here. And we are going to select our whole section here. We go to advanced. Scroll down the options, select display rules, and now we need to switch that on, so enable it, and now we can set up our rules. So let's click on this, and this one is located right at the bottom in all the ACF options. So this one is called text field, so let's select this, and then we need to enter our search field. So this is the cost, obviously, you know, so let's select this. And we have all the different options. So these are information fetched from our custom post type and our custom fields, obviously, you know. And as you can see, this is the one here, number, cost. So let's select this. And now we can set up our rule. So our cost is or isn't empty, then it will display, okay? So let's go to the front end. As you can see, we have a value here, and this is what we want. We want it to display. So automatically, what does that mean? That if it is not empty, display, okay? So let's do this together. So if the cost is not empty, then we want it to display, okay? So let's put this to the test. Now we go to the front end and let's refresh. And there you go. As you can see here, there is no value in the back end. We have no cost. And as a result, that section is not showing anymore. Very good. So now let's have a look at our second case scenario here. So let's click on the view card and let's check the single page. So as you can see here, there is no price, and we have a button here that says request price. Now, if we go back to our listing and select this one, so this one, clearly there's a price, it displayed. And as you can see, we also have a request price on this page, even though the price is being displayed. So what we need to do is to set up a new rule again. So for this, we go back to our car single page. We're going to click on our button here. And again, we go to advanced, scroll down, display rules. So we enable this. And again, we're going to set up our rule here, okay? And again, we're going to select ACF text field here. And we're going to enter the field that we want to search. So again, this one is called cost. So let's search for this. Very good. And again, this is number cost. And now we can set our rule. So this time it's the other way around. When the cost is empty, we want to display this button, okay? So let's click update and let's go back to our front end and let's refresh. And there you go. As you can see, our Renault has a price. So that button, request a quote, is not displaying anymore. Now, if we go back to our listing and click on the BMW that has no price, as you can see, this one is displaying. And you're going to love our next rule. So let's scroll down the page here and we have a frequently asked questions section. So as you can see, this one has 1, 2, and 3 questions that were all answered. So this could be a multi-vendor marketplace. So not everyone is going to answer all the questions or fill out all the details. So in this case, as you can see, with 1, 2, 3 questions being displayed. Now, if we check our other car here, the Renault, if we go to the frequently asked questions section, as you can see, with only 2 questions because only 2 of them were answered. So how can you set up such a rule? Let me show you from the back end. So for this, we go back to our car single page. And the way you set this up is very simple, actually. So what you would do basically is to set up 2 different sections, one that contains 3 questions and one that contains 2 questions. And then you can set different rules for each section. So let's click on the very first one here with 3 questions. And this is the accordion widget. And here you can set up your questions using dynamic content. Now let's set up our display rules. You can scroll down, display rules, and now we can enable this. And let's set up our rule. So again, this will be an ACF text field. And which field are we going to query? This one is under working conditions. So let's search for this. So under, there you go. And as you can see, this is the one here, so is under working condition. And now we can set up our rule. So this one, clearly we want to display it if it's not empty. So is not empty, then it will display, okay? And then we can set the same rule for the other one, but the other way around. So let's do that quickly together. So let's click on this. And again, we're going to advanced. Display rules, enable this, create the rule. This one is under construction is empty, and then update. And now let's put this to the test. So let's have a quick look in the front end. So we have our 3 cars here. So we know that the Renault has no information here under working condition. So let's click on this one, view car, and frequently asked questions. As you can see, we only have 2 questions. Now let's go back to our listing. And let's click on the Ferrari here, for instance. And this one has the information. And as a result, we can see the 3 different questions. So there you go, guys. This is how powerful these display conditions really are. Now, we are open to your suggestions. If your favorite feature is missing, then feel free to add it to our roadmap so that we can hear about your great ideas. And for this, simply go to roadmap.theplusaddons.com. And from there, you can submit your suggestions. And we'd like to thank you in advance for your help and support. Again, if you liked and learned something new in this video, then feel free to share with your friends in your Facebook communities and make sure to hit the like and subscribe button so that YouTube knows that you loved this video. Thanks for watching and we'll see you guys in the next video.